as we approach the end of the second phase of the nationwide lockdown, the Ministry of Home Affairs has said that the restrictions will be eased in several districts from the 4th of May. The Ministry announced on Twitter, and I quote, new guidelines to fight COVID-19 will come into effect from the 4th of May, which shall give considerable relaxations to many districts, end of quote. Now, states are also preparing to ease some norms in line with the centre's guidelines and restart industries and businesses. That will be a key priority. Karnataka's Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa has said the state will allow industries to function in all areas except containment zones from the 4th of May. Punjab, which has become the first state to extend the lockdown by 2 more weeks, has also announced some relaxations. It's allowed industries which could take care of their labour to restart work. Most shops have also been allowed to operate every day during the 4-hour curfew relaxation window. However, that comes with a set of riders. Ensuring the return of stranded migrant workers and students to their home states is also on the top of the agenda for state governments. In fact, Maharashtra has already come out with a set of guidelines to facilitate the movement. People who opt for it will be screened, and only those who don't show symptoms of COVID or influenza will be allowed to leave the state. Well, to talk about the restarting plan, we're now joined by T.S. Singh Deo, the Health Minister of Chhattisgarh. Mr. Deo, many thanks for joining us here on CNBC TV 18. What should we now expect? Is the state of Chhattisgarh in favour of a nationwide lockdown continuing come the 4th of May? Or do you believe that there should now be a much faster exit strategy adopted because the economic consequences are severe and fairly grim?
Good evening, Shireen Ji. While the economic consequences would certainly be grave, but personally, I would feel that we must first protect lives, as many of them as possible. And with that in mind, we should see which sectors and how we can kickstart the economic activities. We have generally these three segments of the economy. We talk about them in terms of the agriculture sector, the service sector, and the manufacturing sector. So each of these sectors should be looked into separately, and their rural and urban scenario, their backgrounds, their economic activity push given to those segments of societies, these should be taken into mind. And concurrent activities of manufacturing, I think, should be focused on those factors. If the agricultural sector is to be the least affected, I believe that will be the least affected by this corona lockdown or restricted activities, then the incomes coming, the purchasing capacity coming from agricultural and allied activities, while it is continued, we should focus on those manufacturing activities which are linked to, let us say, people residing in rural areas. Then how far will we be able to revive the, let us say, the service sector? How many of the banks, how many of the shops, how many of the hotels and the restaurants and the malls, how many other activities in the medical sector, the legal sector, how many of our lawyers? These would again be generating purchasing capacities with their activities. Then the purchasing capacity of this segment, which manufacturing would it affect? We should target on that. And then is the larger manufacturing segment, which would be manufacturing, let us say, steel, power, cement, the mining activity associated with that. How and in which manner can we continue? Are we in a position to start our building sector? And in which segment are we able to start our construction? If the urban areas, which would be the red or the orange spots, these activities are curtailed, then are we in a position to push manufacture of, let us say, cement or steel? Mostly this is what is consumed there. So each sector should be seen as per the reality of its situation, and manufacturing activity allied with that, which would again generate jobs and deepen our pockets for purchasing, greater purchasing
capacity. So, Mr. Singh, I want to understand from you very simply, sir, because there have been many circulars already issued by the Ministry of Home Affairs, which give some flexibility to state governments to undertake relaxations. Now, for instance, the last one, when it comes to shops and establishments and allowing shops and establishments to function with some limited restrictions on which shops can't be allowed to open up. What has been the situation in the state? Have you been able to restart? So if you can lay out a plan of what Chhattisgarh intends to do, sir, now over the next few days.
Frankly, Shirin ji, I won't be able to say what Chhattisgarh would do because the Chief Minister will have to take the call on that. I could say the scenario I see, the rural sector has shown itself to be more disciplined than the urban sector when these lockouts are opened or relaxed. In urban areas, there is much more of a coming out and people are not adhering to either distancing norms or wearing of masks. Such, let us say, preventive measures, because that is all that you can do. There is no medicine. So urban areas seem to not being adhered to that. So whatever activity you open, it should not be completely normal. Have shifts in the morning, have shifts in the afternoon, not a continuation. So that sense must be there. Sense of corona being amongst us must be there.
Okay, so you're saying that open up, but open up with caveats, open up with restrictions, especially in urban areas. Let me bring in the Finance Minister of Punjab, Mr. Manpreet Badal, as well. Mr. Badal, many thanks for joining us here on CNBC TV 18. Now, your government has already decided to extend the lockdown to the 17th of May. Now, I'm confused, sir, because, you know, your party president, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, today, along with the former RBI Governor Raghuram Rajan, has done this show where the message really seems to be that, you know, we need to have a smarter, cleverer reopening. Now, what does that mean, then, if Punjab has already decided to extend, even before waiting for the Prime Minister to address, has already decided to extend till the 17th of May? It also contradicts what your own state government's panel has recommended, suggesting very clearly that if the curfew continues as is, it could jeopardise food security.
I think, Shirin, you've misunderstood the message from Punjab. Agricultural operations are going on unimpeded. In fact, we are set for a bumper harvest and a record procurement. And over the last 70 years, we've fine-tuned this art, you know, this procurement into a fine art. And every grain will be procured and sent to parts of India which require foods. So that is not the problem. And also what the Punjab order says that industry is allowed to open, again, with certain caveats. Construction can go on, no problem. Certain establishments can go on. But if your listeners and if you could appreciate that Punjab is a very special case because almost a third of our population today has emigrated out of Punjab and emigrated to what is known as the first world, you know, which are the current hotspots, which is the US, Canada, England. You know, you have more Punjab federal ministers in Canada than you have in India. So we are aware that, you know, we cannot allow any kind of relaxation on that score. But apart from that, I think, and I was listening to my very good friend, and can you just convey my salams to him, Mr. Dio?
He can hear you, sir.
Okay.
Good evening,
Mantri
ji. Hi.
Salam. Sat Sri Akal, sir. Greetings from Punjab. And so I think we are, apart from certain restrictions, the whole of the population is indulging in some meaningful economic activity. And what I could partially hear my friend, Mr. Dio, was that basically, there are two problems now, and I'm concerned about that. One is that the supply chain for the entire economic activity or industry or whatever you may call, that stands ruptured. Even if we were to lift the lockdown completely and entirely, how do you restore the entire, you know, the chain which has been disrupted? Even if you were to, Shirin, restore the entire chain, I'm actually concerned about the demand. Where, you know, where is the demand going to come from? I mean, you're sitting in the studio. Would you like to buy a new pair of shoes today? Would you like to buy a new pair of shirt or a new car? You know, people have lost their livelihood. Sure. People have lost their jobs. They have suffered losses in their businesses. I don't think so. There's money floating around to be able to create that kind of a demand.
Yes, but it's a chicken and egg situation. You talked about not the demand not being there because there is a sense of insecurity, financial insecurity. But people are feeling that insecurity because they're locked down and unable to carry on their business activity, unable to restart their businesses. And so I want to understand from you what your interpretation is of the MHA tweet that came in yesterday saying that there will be significant relaxation come the 4th, but details are awaited. So, you know, specifically from Punjab's point of view, and I know that this is, again, something that you spoke of, that industrial activity has started. But, you know, this classification of essential, non-essential, why shouldn't the government allow all goods to be manufactured? Shouldn't that be the way forward now?
Well, that is the way forward. And we've asked the industry industry which we can make sure that the labor can either be housed within the premises or the industry which can arrange special transportation to get the labor to the premises and back to their homes. If that can be arranged, that is allowed. But we just can't afford to have people just walking around aimlessly, or, you know, public transportation can't start, barber shops, cinemas, sure, restaurants. I mean, you know, we have to be careful of that.
Yeah, of course. I don't think anyone is suggesting that you reopen cinema halls or schools and colleges, etc., at this point in time. But I also want to understand from you, Mr. Badal, and I know that the Punjab government specifically has been requesting the centre to allow the opening up of liquor shops because that is a source of revenue and most states find themselves dealing with a very precarious fiscal position. Do you expect that that is a relaxation that will be granted? If not, what about the state's revenues?
Shirin, I look at it from a different angle. You know, if you don't allow alcohol, you know, A, Punjab does not promote alcohol, neither do we discourage it. You know, it's a matter of individual choice. Somebody wants to have a Pepsi or a Coca-Cola or alcohol, that's up to him. But you must appreciate that if somebody has disposable income and if the government can tax that, you know, especially for alcohol, our entire excise revenues actually go into our social security system. We have a very robust social security system. So why shouldn't this money be given to the poorest of the poor, you know, kind of a safety net? But what I am also concerned about is that if you don't allow sale of alcohol, then people will try and get alcohol from somewhere. Either, you know, you'll have mafias coming up, brewing their own illicit alcohol, selling them at some kind of a prohibitive, you know, 7-8 times the cost of the original. And, you know, as a border state, which is constantly, you know, we're sitting on a live border, you know, we get destabilized by our immediate neighbors. I don't want these mafias to come up in Punjab. I mean, these are the enemies of the state.
Okay.
And we have to be wary of them.
Okay. All right. You know, you spoke of excise. Let me ask both you as well as Mr. Singhdeo that question. We've seen, for instance, the Rajasthan government hike excise duties on liquor. Will you look at hiking excise duties across liquor, perhaps even petrol and diesel? Is that something that you're considering at this point in time to shore up revenues?
Alcohol, certainly. Petroleum, I'm not very sure because it would be like rubbing salt into the wounds of people who are already under stress. But certainly, these are the only two avenues which are open to the state. Punjab would also be trying very hard to slash or make some cuts in our revenue expenditure. We may even have to defer some of our capital expenditure defer it for next year. I don't know, Shirin. My reply would be calibrated every day by the developing situation.
Fair point. I understand that completely. But Mr. Singhdeo, same question to you, sir. What is the state looking to do at this point in time to provide relief to those that require relief, but at the same time, balance your books?
Shirin ji, there are two aspects to this. There could be more. One is, what is the government going to do with money it realizes from taxes? Don't get me wrong. I hope the viewers don't do either. But what is the government thinking of doing with this? Giving it back to the people in one form or the other and converting into some development project alongside. How are you going to get money for revenue from, let us say, excise, the sale of liquor. Who's going to pay for that?
Yeah.
It is the people. Yeah. Their pockets would be paying for that liquor. And the government gains revenue. The person who spends the money on liquor, he spends a resource, a purchasing capacity, which could go into purchasing, let us say, clothes, or it could go into purchasing some other food products, or it could go into purchasing a motorcycle. It could go into some other purchase, which in its turn would help the economy. So you have a catch-22 situation where on one side, liquor, some people like it, they have a right to like it, they enjoy having liquor, then state revenue is there, and lot of women, I mean, I would feel 90-95% if you have a secret poll, they would say, hey, stop the sale of liquor. So it is a catch-22 situation. The money would be available through purchase from rather than liquor something else for other resources also.
Okay. All right. So the message from Punjab as well as Chhattisgarh is that while both states are looking at opening up and awaiting guidelines from the center, it will also have restrictions in place to ensure that there is no surge in the coronavirus cases. But Punjab also looking at further relaxations, as is Chhattisgarh at this point in time. Gentlemen, thanks very much for joining us here on CNBC TV 18 with your take on the restarting plan come the 3rd of May. Up next, we touch base with Jagdish Shetter, the Industries Minister of Karnataka, on Karnataka's plan. Don't go anywhere. Well, to understand more on Karnataka's plan come the 3rd of May, joining us now is the Industry Minister, Mr. Jagdish Shetter. Mr. Shetter, many thanks for joining us. There was a cabinet meeting that you had in Karnataka this morning. What is the decision of the government? What should we expect come the 3rd of May? Of course, we're still waiting to see what the national lockdown will look like. But within the state, what will you allow? What have you decided?
Here in Karnataka, regarding starting of industry is concerned, we have divided entire state three zones, red zone and orange zone and green zone. In the green zone, 14 districts will come, and orange zone, 8 districts will come, and another 8 districts, they are red zones. And here in green zones, almost all state government has given clearance to start the all type of industry. If any in all 14 districts, there is no containment area, there is no report of the positive cases. In that 14 districts, we allowed to start the industry, all types of start industry. In the orange zone, 8 districts are there, 5 positive cases are there, 7 positive cases are there. So we have earmarked as containment area. Out of the jurisdiction of the containment area, we have allowed to start the industries, we have allowed to start the shops as per the definition of the Shops and Establishment Act. In the orange zone also, in even green zone also, all the shops we have to arrange to start the activities of the shops also, industry also, in 14 districts and 8 districts also, with a limited some restrictions, we allowed industries and also shops. In red zones, we have not allowed and restrictions are continued as early as water restrictions there, and only the essential manufacture of goods, those industries has been allowed in red zones.
You're saying that in red zones only essential services will continue, no further relaxations at this point in time, but in orange zones and in green zones you have allowed up to
May 3rd in red zones, apart that containment area will be restricted, and out of the jurisdiction of the containment area, we are allowing essential production of the industries that will be allowed in the red zones. And regarding green zones, almost all industries, we are directed to start the industries in green zones.
Okay. So even within red zones, what you're saying is that outside of the containment areas, you will allow industrial activity to start. But what about Bangalore and Mysore, sir? Because that's the hub as far as the state of Karnataka is concerned. Are you looking at any relaxations for Bangalore and Mysore?
Particularly Bangalore and Mysore, as per the earlier direction of the central government and state government, we allowed the industries who are considered as the essential manufacturing industries, those have been already allowed in the red zones out of the containment area, and that is still continued. This is still continued in Bangalore and Mysore.
Now, how many units have started functioning, sir? Because there has been confusion on who can start, whether they've been given state government approval or not. How many units have already started functioning outside of the essential services?
Here in the in our state, we have given authority to the industry department joint directors, that is a DIC of the concerned district. They have been authorized to start the industry, give the permission to starting up the industry, and with some precautions has to be taken, and self declaration of all the conditions we are taking from the industry list, and JD joint director is authorized to give the permission. Accordingly, this activity is started already.
Are you asking industry that they will have to keep labor on premises, on location? What is the condition that has been attached besides, of course, social distancing, etc.? Because this is a concern that industry has raised with many state governments. Are you saying that industry that's restarting will have to house labor on premises?
Definitely, we put a condition, taking up the precaution, and regarding compulsory mask to the labors, and hand sanitization, that is compulsory, and social distance they have to maintain in the industry, that we conditions imposed on them. And even regarding workers is concerned, transportation of the workers is concerned, it is a responsibility of the industrial owner. He has to arrange for the transportation, because there is no service of the bus, there is no service of the metro, there is no service of the railway also.
What is the response from industry? Because if they have to organize even transportation, will they be able to do so in this current period? What's the feedback that you've got?
Another condition we put is 50% workers, they have to be taken now at the present. And after imposing all these conditions, so many industrialists agreed for that. And there is a good response from the industrialist, but some problems are there. Even after giving permission also, some problems with the police department, some problems with the other officers, that is the same. Wherever the problems arises, we are sorting out problems. And so many delegations also, they are meeting as an industry minister, for me also, our officer also, they are telling the some problems. We are solving those problems also. But so many people, industrialists, they are ready to start.
Mr. Shetter, what about stranded migrant workers who may be stuck in the state of Karnataka? What is that number? What is your discussion with other states on being able to send the migrant labor back to their respective states? Because now the MHA has given the go-ahead for that.
Here, regarding this aspect also, yesterday there is a guidance issued from the union government. That also we received, and regarding that guidance also, it is discussed in our cabinet meeting also, today's cabinet meeting, and accordingly, we agreed for the guidance issued by the union government regarding migrant workers is there. If Karnataka people are there in the Bihar,
yeah,
or in Uttar Pradesh, it is allowed to come to Karnataka.
Yes.
In Karnataka, Bihar people are there, Andhra people are there, so many other states laborers are there, migrant laborers. We are ready to send to them respective states.
So when will this process start? When will the process start, sir, of the Karnataka government sending labor that's stranded in your state back to their respective states? And what has been your conversation with states like UP, Bihar, etc., of getting stranded labor back to your state?
Yesterday night only, that guidelines have been issued by the government of India. Government yesterday only night. And today, cabinet meeting, morning we discussed all these issues and all these guidelines, and we also given consent for this guidelines, and the process started from today or tomorrow onwards. Entire process will start.
So final question, Mr. Shetter, you know, you're saying that there are problems on the ground, there's issues with approvals with the police and so on and so forth. Industry is keen to restart but haven't really been able to restart as of now. Do you believe that by Monday a lot of these issues will be sorted out? You know, what's your expectation? Will 50%, 30%, 20%, how much of industrial activity in the state of Karnataka will resume?
Definitely, it is a starting trouble, and though we have given the clearance for the starting of the industry, so people already started coming, there is good response, and so many people, they are preparing for the starting up their industry. Some difficulties are there, and we are sorting out all the difficulties, and whatever the from help from the police department and other departments in starting and coordinating for transporting of workers is concerned, we are looking into all the matters. I think initially from Monday onwards, almost all they will start the industry. At least from beginning, 30% to 40% industry will start from up to Monday.
30% to 40% industry should be able to start by Monday.
Yes.
Mr. Shetter, many thanks for joining us here on CNBC TV 18. Appreciate your time. That's
you.
The industry minister of Karnataka there on what the plan is with the restarting of economic activity.